Hello, and welcome to Under 1000. My name's Thomas Flower, and each episode I'll read you a new piece of flash fiction. All of the stories are 1000 words or less. Today, I'll be reading Lovesick. Please be aware that this episode contains strong language and characters vomiting. If that's likely to upset you, or anyone that you're listening with, then you might want to skip this one.
"Get out the loo, I'm about to hurl again,"
came the demanding voice from outside the bathroom. "What a charmer," Dan thought sarcastically to himself, as he washed his hands at double speed and flung open the door to a distinctly green-looking Eduardo. "Honey, I love you, but please, please, please get out the fucking way," was his boyfriend's only reaction. Dan stepped aside, looking on with pity, as Eduardo flung his head into the toilet bowl and began retching loudly once again. It had been 3 days now, Dan realised. Friday, Saturday and Sunday, all ruined by this horrible little vomiting bug. He didn't know whether bacterial cells could understand curses, but in his head he cursed them nonetheless. "You want me to put the kettle on again? Would another cup of fruity tea help when you're done?" he called out, trying to make himself heard over the splashing of bile against toilet bowl. A faint groan emanated from the porcelain, which he took as a yes. As he flicked the switch on the kettle, Dan began to ponder what this meant for the two of them. When Eduardo had texted him on Friday evening asking to be taken care of for the weekend, Dan had wondered if things were moving too fast. After all, they'd only just breached saying "I love you" and staying over for multiple nights in a row, taking care of one another, with the spectre of domesticity that it hinted towards, seemed like a prospect that neither of them should be ready for yet. But Dan had risen to the challenge, surprising himself by relishing in his new role as cook, caretaker, and counsellor. The kettle clicked off, the tiny sound seeming deafening in the otherwise quiet room. Dan snapped out of his thoughts. He poured a cup of blueberry tea for them each, and returned to see how his vomit-covered darling was doing. "Here's your tea, honey. How are you feeling now?" "Terrible," Eduardo replied immediately, no longer even pretending to be struggling valiantly. He had wanted, when he awoke that morning, to be able to convince his worried boyfriend that things were looking up, but the reality of the situation had hit him too hard to be able to lie convincingly. "Do you want me to take the day off tomorrow? I've got some spare time I could use. They wouldn't like me doing it at a moment's notice, I guess, but if you need me to, I don't mind," Dan asked softly, the concern showing in his eyes more clearly than ever now. Eduardo thought for a moment. He felt honour-bound to say he could tough it out, go it alone and be all right, but the prospect didn't sound very appealing, and eventually he relented to himself. "That would be nice. If it's all right. Thank you. You really are being too good to me during this," he replied in an equally hushed tone, before taking a sip of tea to calm his stomach. The two lay in bed together for a moment, pondering to themselves while they finished the ends of their mugs. When they were both done, Dan got up again and took the cups. "You should rest now," he said, as he made a move towards the bedroom door. "I'm going to wash these up, and then I'll do some reading in the living room. You take a nap, get some sleep if you can. I think it would help." Once again, Eduardo was tempted to refuse, but once again he relented. As Dan closed the door, he lay back and began to doze gently. With the mugs laying in the kitchen sink, Dan sat to ponder once again. He realised, suddenly, that this had all been a test. Not one set explicitly, of course. He knew that Eduardo hadn't devised a devious scheme to fall ill and check his boyfriend's commitment, but still, it had tested their commitment to one another regardless. Though saying, "I love you," for the first time had seemed quite a hurdle, Dan wondered if perhaps this was the more serious event after all. It seemed to him that it marked the move away from the passionate honeymoon phase, and into the drab, domestic, and sometimes difficult part of the relationship, which would ultimately be its defining feature. They were moving into something new, but after this weekend, that didn't seem so scary anymore. Dan knew that Eduardo now knew that he was committed. He knew that his boyfriend would understand that he would be there, no matter what. Not just as a grand declarative romantic statement, but very literally. He would clean vomit and wash dishes and keep life running when Eduardo was incapable of it. And, he thought silently to himself, perhaps that was the greatest proof of his love after all. Dan had always thought of love in the terms of romance books and Disney films, but he realized now that he'd been short-sighted. True, lasting love isn't found in happy ever afters, romance novels, and grand sweeping poetry, he mused to himself. That love is fickle, dramatic, and ultimately incomplete. If you want to know it's real, try chucking up your guts for 2 days and seeing if they'll still stand by you. And Dan had stood by, choosing to stay despite the dull grossness of it all. He loved Eduardo, truly, deeply, wonderfully dispassionately. A wave of emotion overcoming him slightly, he wandered from the living room back to the bedroom. Eduardo was fast asleep now, snoring a little, in a way that was as irritating as it was adorable. Dan climbed into bed beside him, wrapping his arms around this man he had only just realized how much he truly cared for. He wasn't sure how things would develop between them in the future, but now he knew it would be all right. A weekend of vomiting had shown him how things might be. Thank you for listening to Under 1000. I'm your host, Thomas Flower. To follow the show online, look for Under 1000 Pod on Twitter or Facebook. If you'd like to support the show on Patreon, go to patreon.com/under1000pod, where you can sign up to read each month's stories in advance, as well as to have a thank you be read during these credits. The theme music is an instrumental version of In Between Days by Nick Tate and the Sharks. To hear the full song and more from the same EP, go to Nick Tate, NICTATE, andthesharks.bandcamp.com, or search for them on your favourite streaming platform. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and that you'll join me again next time for some more super short fiction.